Trans March was one of the most empowering events in my life. I'd say, out of two events, surgery and Trans March, these are the most empowering events I've ever been a part of, gone through, besides being in a very healthy, happy relationship with my girlfriend. That's definitely an event, but it's a continuous one. So, surgery was definitely an empowering event, and it allowed me to live in the body that I was meant to live in and to be myself. But Trans March allowed all that to come together socially and communally with friends in a beautiful place. And if you've never been, you should definitely go to San Francisco for Trans March. I believe it's June 27th this year. And I felt so empowered as a person being with thousands of other trans people and knowing it was okay. You know, for a while I was very self-identified, did not identify with the trans side of me, you know, just kind of put my trans history aside. But, you know, then you kind of feel, well, I kind of felt depressed and isolated and lonely. And, you know, especially being one of the only trans guys here and not feeling like I can have anyone to relate to. So all of a sudden being around thousands of people that were all different colors of the rainbow, all different genders, all different sexualities, you know, just come together and just have fun together and then march, you know, for equal rights and against violence against trans people. It was just this amazing, empowering event, being with my best friends. And the only thing missing was my beautiful girlfriend. So this year it will be amazing to have my girlfriend by my side, also on her 21st birthday weekend, and also my best friend and then other friends around. You know, it will feel so empowering for me to have her, a non-trans person, be there, because she just totally, fully accepts us and is there for the same reasons I am and is just totally all about it. And that just means so much to me because, you know, she's not always dated queer folk. So I am just super excited about Trans March. It was just amazing to walk through the beautiful streets of San Francisco just with trans people and their supporters and their friends and allies, and just see the signs that said, "We love our tranny brothers and sisters," held up by straight people or other queer people that were not trans, just in there for support. I remember I just was holding back tears half the time because I remember when we were first starting out marching, there was a family, a straight couple, with their children, you know, one's in a baby stroller, that said, holding up a sign that says, "Just another anarchist family for trans liberation." And I was like, okay, we are not in the South anymore. You know, definitely in San Francisco, and it just made me so happy, and I get so emotional at those things. But I will never forget that time with my brothers there. It was definitely a time for me to grow and just to feel whole as a person, and I just felt happy, and I can't wait for my girlfriend to be there to experience that with me so she can see me like that and really know, like, this is where we're supposed to be. So I'm excited for that, and that's all I have to say.